extent. Massive, monstrous game. Can the Roo boys get there? These sides have met in round four. North won by 7 goals. In fact, 43 points. Sydney were without Goods, Tippett, Reed and Bird. So it's at the ANZ Stadium, 7 p.m. tomorrow night. Parko, let's have a look at the Sydney team. No change.
No change. And underpinned there that Goods 350th, which is a remarkable effort. I think Sydney are just the complete unit. I don't see any weakness at all in that lineup. You might say their capability to win in the wet, and I have checked the forecast, and they're going to get rain, so rain's on the forecast. They've lost three of their four against opposition, including North Melbourne this year, in the rain, so that gives them, I think, some sort of psychological advantage. But when you look at that team, and Bird, Derek, Jack B, Laidler, Membry, Mitchell and O'Keefe aren't in it. You talk about a healthy list and top four, they've got it. Those blokes would be in most other sides. So for me, that's a sensational indication of where they are. I'm interested where they're going to play Franklin. He pushed up the other week against Richmond. And I think with that structure, he'll certainly play further up the ground. And he's playing as good a football as I've ever seen him play. They're not big on lockdown taggers. And who would you go? You were arguing before. Is it Harvey? Is it Del Santo? Is it Wells or Gibson? Four that are in real good form now. They've tended not to go the full way, but Cunningham has been doing it a bit over the last few weeks. And look, they're the best forward defensive team and concede least scores from turnovers. They've got a lot going for them, Sydney.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's have a look at the forecast too is for relatively fine weather tomorrow night. North Melbourne, one change.
You just said it was going to rain.
I just checked it up and it was definitely going to be wet.
During the day, Parker. It's going to clear up in the evening. I just got told that anyway.
Yeah,
okay, exactly. Let's have a look at the North Melbourne ins and outs, Shory.
Yeah, well, Benny Jacobs comes in, McMillan out with a hamstring.
That's a shame.
That was a shame because he's been in pretty good form over the last month. Really good that... One thing about North, they are fantastic. Once they get the ball inside their 50, they convert better than anybody in the competition. And the other one that stands out, when they win possession and control the game, they win the game. So they're up, they plus 45 possessions when they win a game. When they lose a game, they're minus 35. So it's whether you can starve North from getting it. I totally agree. I don't know. Their midfield now has gone to a new level with who do you have to tag or who can you tag. And one player who, Dermy, I did call him a B-grader.
Well, you B-graded him.
2 weeks ago.
Because
Nick Delsando. Yeah, hold on. Because I thought in big games, he wasn't able to cope with taggers. Well, over the last 2 weeks, he's now worked into an A-grade situation. And this is probably what it's about. He is an outside player, but he's a smart player. He brings others into the game. He draws people to him so he can set things up like this. But have a look at this work rate. This is what's made him good in this final series. Now, he intercepts here this handball. There's Motlop behind him. Watch his work rate. Now, look at Nicky Dell get on there. Look at Motlop still in the 50 zone. That's about a 25-metre thing within about 2 seconds. He keeps running. He's telling the bloke behind him, take that bloke away, take my opposition player away, and he gets this ball here. That is why he's come to the fore in finals footy.
There's Motlop.
Where is Motlop? He's not there anyway.
He's just crept into the back of the screen.
There you go. Well, that's two different stories in that one bit of tape, isn't it? But that's why he's really become an important player in this final series.
He certainly has and can use it. I thought his disposal was unbelievable on the weekend. Okay, Parko, let's have a look at your midfield comparison.
Well, this is another further evidence of what Sydney bring to the game. Hanbury, Jack Kennedy, McGlynn, McGay. You've got six that you might argue this that I believe are A graders. I've got four on the, and we've mentioned those before, except for Cunnington on the North Melbourne side. So in terms of what's the word, absolute skill, I think that Sydney are a significant step ahead. And when you look at the balance of those who can get, who are both inside and outside, and those who can really win the ball as tough insiders, and then they've got, of course, the Jetta Rowan type people who can carry it beautifully on the outside and use it. I just think there's a distinct, only running nine each through. I was amazed. Yeah. I thought it'd be up to 11 or 12. But last week they only ran nine through with an unchanged side. To me, that's limited. But North are no better in that regard.
Can I just throw one in on the back of it with Goldstein against Pike? Does that swing it a little bit? Favours him back the other way?
I think Goldstein and Petrie's done a little bit, but not too much to assist
Goldstein
him.
Goldstein doesn't like change.
He goes the whole way. 90%. Pike and Reed is about the similar quantity. There is no doubt in my mind the one advantage they have, Goldstein was brilliant against Geelong. Yep. So that's the advantage.
Okie doke. Moons, let's have a look at the Swannies forwards against the Kangaroo backmen. They're all yours.
Okay, so we look at some of the matchups down here. And look, we're going to see, obviously, Tippett, Buddy, Goods, you know, all over 190 centimetres. Tippett in particular, 101 centimetres, 104 kilos. He's coming up against Grimer at 192. Franklin, you know, 198. Thompson, 193. And he's also 103 kilos there, Buddy. You know, Goods probably is going to have to stay on right. But this is the one I want to look at, Reed and Ferrito. I mean, Reed didn't have a great game last week or 2 weeks ago, we know that. But 196 centimetres, Reed. Ferrito, 189. Now, we see this a couple of weeks ago when Ferrito manned up on Danaher. Absolutely got done. Got absolutely. He just couldn't handle. He has never really handled the really big guys. Now, we know Danaher is one of those abnormal guys with a really long reach. But when Reed gets a run and jump at it, he's as good as anybody in the air. So that's going to be the big matchup for me that we're going to be looking
at. He doesn't handle big guys who are agile and move at the ball carrier. And that showed twice in that situation. And Sammy Reed's got to get on his bike a little bit. Start deep, but when he has to go, you're right, that's where he does get caught out for it.
And the other one we're going to look at, I mean, they're defenders as a whole, and I did speak about a couple of those matchups before. Now, this is what we saw last week. Tom Hawkins, you know, we know he's 197, 105 kilos. You know, he's a big man. He monstered Grimer. He monstered Thompson at times. And we just saw Ferrito get monstered a couple of times with Danaher. Now, we're talking about one guy who did this to North Melbourne. Now, we're talking about Tippett, who hasn't even fired yet.
No,
this is the big puzzle in the piece for Sydney that's still yet to fire. Buddy's at his absolute peak. So can they handle these big key forwards from Sydney? And I've got big question marks on them, Parker.
I'm with you. I think that's the difference. Even if they match them in the midfield, reasonable delivery in, that's going to be the difference between the two teams.
They're still saying Tom's 105. I reckon he should put the other foot on. He's got 105 covered all day long. All righty. Benny Dixon had the chance to talk. Kingy, actually, went straight to our man for the source and had this quote from Buddy Franklin.
Thanks, boys. Key matchup this weekend I'm looking forward to, Lance Buddy Franklin versus Scott Thompson. These two have played on each other five of the last six occasions. Buddy Franklin's in career best form, 70 goals. Scott Thompson's conceded 36 goals for the year. A few more goals than Brad Scott would like from a key defender. But he's kept the big Budwar goalless the last two times they've met and his direct opponent six times this year. Let's take a look at how you stop the best player in the game. Buddy Franklin loves the 40 to 60 metre zone clear. Gives him running space, but more importantly, turns. He's got the big arc. Fremantle op for a player in front. Distracts the player, but more importantly, confusion with Buddy Franklin is what you want. You don't want him to free flow. Silvani there had no contest. Mzungu in his space. Could have killed him. Didn't. How do you play the best player in the game? The Kangas have got their work cut out with the Bondi Billionaires and my boy Buddy.
Benny Dixon there. Sorry, Benny Dixon put that piece together for us. And also David King had the chance to go out and speak with Buddy Franklin. So let's go to that now.
Kicked over 100 goals in 2008. Never wants to refer back to that year as probably your best year. This year's been a different year in terms of the number of goals, but do you feel like you're in career best form?
Yeah, I was 21 back then. It was 6 years ago, so I think everyone's always going to judge me on goals kicked. But for me, I think it's been a pretty good season for me. I think 2012 was a pretty good season for me too. I think last year was too, but it was everyone always brings it back to goals kicked. And this year's probably been a little bit, like I said, all-round game. I think my marking's improved a little bit this season. And my goal kicking has improved too. I've put a lot of work into it in the off season with Nick Davis, and it's paying off. But I've got to kick the goals on the big stage in big games, and against Hawthorn two times I kicked a lot of points, so that was a bit disappointing. But just as long as I'm doing my practice and make sure I've got my routine down pat, hopefully I can pay off on the big stage.
Thank you, Kingy, and you're going to hear more of that in the pre-game show. Look, for this match, Friday night game show, we'll see this 7 p.m. We've got Eddie Maguire, Michael Voss, Lynchy, Jared Healy, Kingy, Mark McClure, Brad Johnson, Buddy Franklin, and Brad Scott. They'll be crossing to him before the game also, and he'll have his little say there. But for this game, the Swannies and North Melbourne, still great seats available to this match for just $45. For tickets and more information, head to afl.com.au. Tony Shaw, let's have a look at the other end of the ground, yes, and the matchups here with the North forwards, Swans backs.
Yeah, well, it's pretty well self-explanatory in a lot of ways. So I've gone with Grundy goes to Brown, Richards will go to Petrie, Rampy might play on a Zeeble if he pushes forward, but my Builders Academy Australia key matchup I'm looking at tonight is Nick Smith on Lindsay Thomas. Now, I think they've played twice. Over the last two times they've played, Lindsay Thomas has only kicked three goals. So Nick Smith is an all-Australian back pocket player. I think Lindsay Thomas, he's a bit like Ballantyne. If he scores, and that, what a great rundown by Nick Smith there. We'll probably see a better one a bit later. But I don't know how he got forward of him on this occasion. He's got to watch that. But the way that he just works in it. Look at this. Look at the want to chase and tackle. Just gets a fingernail on him and stops him from kicking a goal. So I think if he can keep Lindsay Thomas to that, on average at the moment, 1.5 goals, he doesn't want this to occur, that he gets forward a game and they beat him in the wet up there in round four. So that's the matchup for the day, I think. So Nick Smith's got a big job, but he's done it all year.
Thanks to our friends at Builders Academy, and that is for the key matchup. That's the Simmons Group, Moons. They named your ground down there. Simmons Stadium, same
there
people. Gary and Mark Simmons
good
there.
Good man.
All righty, let's take a look at Ted Richards. Ted Richards, we caught up with him during the week. He had this to say.
We both got drafted the same year. I think we've been playing on each other for about 13 or 14 years now. Drew's another guy that I don't think probably gets the recognition that he deserves. I think Drew's even kicked four on me in one quarter back a couple of years ago. He's a big guy that can take the stoppages, you know, in the forward 50. Yet he's, for a big guy, he's incredibly mobile. He's got a great contested mark and moves well, and he's also quite physical.
Now, if you want to see that battle between Drew Petrie and Teddy Richards, along with all the others, $45. You can still get tickets for $45. For more information, head to afl.com.au. Don't go quietly. Moons, not quietly. Who are you going for? How much?
I'm going for Sydney. I think everyone's going for Sydney this week, but I think it's going to be a bit of a blowout, boys. I think there's always a close one, and there's always a blowout. I think this one's the blowout. I think North's run has been enormous and amazing.
I don't know, my glasses.
And I think it will come to an end, Shorey.
Is that 56 points?
That is 56 points. I believe
you're
Sydney
on something. What are you on? Come on. I want some of it.
Mark, you're 17, put three goals just inside.
I think they'll do better than that. He might be right. The one chance of a big blowout to me is this game. But I think it's unlikely.
Yeah, I'm going 15 points. I think conditions, if it's a bit slippery, it does suit North, but...
First, six. You blokes are crazy. You're getting
What's
old,
that?
You blokes.
What's
too
that?
Old. First on the ladder, six on the ladder. Big difference there.
Yeah, well, hold on. They've still got 22 against 22. They're going
crazy,
out there. They're not going out there, are they, North?
Magnificent. Let's go to a break now. After the break, the All-Australian night. We'll have a look at that. And also, in case you missed it, we've been living somewhere else for the last 24 hours. Brenton Sanderson cast aside by the...